Hello everyone! In this video, I will show you calculation of reduced levels by height of collimation method. In this way, reduced level is calculated for each instrument position. This table shows backsight, foresight, height of the plane collimation, also known as collimation level or HPC. Initial reduced level, adjustment, adjusted reduced level, and remarks. For this leveling experiment, only one benchmark was available. Therefore, leveling line ran in loops, starting and finishing at the same benchmark. Okay, firstly, we will type initial reduced level of benchmark, as it is known and cannot be changed. Then, we add backside value of benchmark to reduced level of benchmark. It will give us HPC value for the first instrument position. So, it will be 321.107 and it will be typed on HPC column. Now, to find initial reduced level of A point, foresight value will be subtracted from HPC and it will be 320.866. We can see that at each point the instrument was moved, and it means for every point we will have new HPC value. So for position A, the HPC value is 321.244. The foresight reading now will be subtracted from this HPC value to get reduced level, and it will be 321.059. We repeat the same procedure until initial reduced level of benchmark in the last row is calculated. Okay, now we apply our first check. So the sum of backside values is 8.113 and foresight sum is 8.105 and difference is 0.008. And here the difference between last initial reduced level and first reduced level is 0.008. Then we apply our second check, and here the sum of reduced level except the first one is 1928.255, and when we add it to foresight sums it will be 1936.36. As to calculate reduced level, all HPC have been used once. For this case, we will just sum up all HPC values and it will be 1936.36. Okay, we completed checking initial reduced level and it is acceptable. Now we will find misclosure and allowable misclosure. We will type our benchmark reading to our adjusted reduced level as its fixed value, and their difference will give us misclosure, which is equal to minus 0.008 meter or 8 millimeter. Then we will find allowable misclosure using this equation, which will be equal to 12 millimeter. And we can see that leveling is acceptable. Next, we distribute minus 0.008 meter among each instrument position. Now adjustment is applied for each point except the benchmark, as this level cannot be changed. Okay, that's it. Thank you very much for watching the video, and I will see you next time. Bye!